class we have completed electric lines of course, properties of electric lines of course. There one of the very important point is no two electric lines of force intersect each other. Reason is at the point of intersection, suppose if the two lines of force are intersect each other, at the point of intersection, if you draw tangent on the individual curve, it will give two directions of resultant electric field intensity. That is not possible. At a point, there should be a one resultant electric field, but it will give two directions of resultant electric field. That is not possible. That's why no two lines of force cross each other. And then we have seen line integral of electric field. Are you come across this relation, line integral of electric field? This is the equation we have come across. That is what? Work done to move the charge from A to B is negative integral of line integral of electric field, that is E vector dot dl vector A to B. Okay, so we have seen Q into Q0 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. So line integral of electric field that is negative integral of electric field is E vector dot dl vector is the work done to move a unit positive charge from one point to another point. Are you able to see the video? Yes. Now we are going to see electric potential. Electric potential. This is the topic we have seen earlier. Through video you might have seen electric field is the conservative field. Work then electric field is a conservative field. Here work done by the electric force in the electric field is depends upon the initial and the final position only. So work done by the electric force, it does not depend upon path taken by the body. Okay. The next topic is electric potential. All are able to hear me? Yes. No sound there. All you had your breakfast? Yes, sir. Be happy. Be happy in learning electric potential. Then only you will take something in your mind. So electric potential. See, electric potential, it is a characteristic of electric field. It is a characteristic of electric field, but does not depend upon test charge. Does not depend upon test charge. And this electric potential is a scalar quantity. Even though electric potential is the characteristics of electric field, electric field is a vector quantity, whereas electric potential is a scalar quantity. And this particular quantity only determines the flow of charge from one body to another. Okay, the electric potential is the quantity responsible for flow of charge from one body to another. One body to another. Okay. So it is a physical quantity which determines degree of electrification of a body also. Okay. More potential means, so the degree of electrification of the body is more. Okay. What is the symbol we are going to see? Electric potential. V. V is the capital V is the symbol we are going to see. Electric potential. Okay. What is the definition of this electric potential? So electric potential at a point in an electric field is the work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that point against the electrostatic force irrespective of the path followed. Remember once again, work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to that point against the force due to electric field. Against the force due to electric field. Okay. So now, see here. Just now I told electric potential in an electric field, it is the work done, amount of work done moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that point against the force due to electric field. That is, V is equal to work done to bring a charge, unit positive charge from infinity to that point, particular point, that is W infinity to the P by S charge. Okay, that is unit positive charge. Who is coming? Anjit, now lot of trouble is there for me admitting here, taking a lot of time. So let us will see how to calculate the electric potential. See here, this particular I'm going to have a source charge here, Q. Okay, source charge Q here. So around this source charge, what type of field will be there? Electric field will be there. Around this electric field, we are going to consider one point P. This is point P. At a distance R meter from the source charge. Are you able to follow? Yes. Now, what is the direction of electric field due to this source charge? This is the direction of electric field. Pointing outward. Now, as per the electric potential definition, we have to bring a unit positive charge, that is 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to the point P. How much of work is done? How much of work is done to bring unit positive charge from infinity to that point. Infinity to that point. Now, Jane Susan. Okay. So, we are going to consider, we assume that 1 coulomb of charge is where? At the point A. Now, this point A, which is at a distance of x meter from where? Charge Q. Here we are considered plus 1 coulomb of charge where? At point A. So what is the force experienced by this 1 coulomb of charge due to this electric field? What is the electrostatic force acting on this 1 coulomb of charge due to this source charge Q? What is the? Are you able to listen to me or not? Listening or not? Hey, what is the force acting on this 1 coulomb of charge due to the charge plus Q? KQ by x squared here. KQ by x squared because 1 coulomb of charge is at a distance. We had assumed that this 1 coulomb of charge is where at A. So, what is electric potential? Amount of work done to bring 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to the point P. Infinity is far away. Therefore, what we are going to do? First, we are going to find out what is small work done to take this 1 coulomb of charge from A to B. For this small amount of work is done. Okay. So, if we are, this is, let us consider a charge Q at O. To find the electric potential at the point B, consider at any instant the unit positive charge is at a point A. At point A. Are you able to follow? So, small amount of work done in moving unit positive charge from A to B through a distance dx. What is the formula? dW is equal to F into dx into cos 180. Why? Because this is here. This is force due to electric field. This is force due to electric field. What is the direction we are going to move? Opposite direction. What is the angle between these two? 180 degree. That's why we put together F into dx into cos 180. Cos 180 value is minus 1. So you will get a minus f into dx. Cos 180's value is minus 1. So I have already told you what is the force acting on this 1 coulomb of charge. KQ by x squared. So I have substituted the value of f here. This is a small amount of work done to take the charge from where? A to B here. A to B in this direction. In this direction. Whereas force due to electric field this direction. That's why we put here 180 degree here. Okay. So, now you see here. Now. Total work done to bring a unit positive charge from where? Infinity to that point P. So, what we are going to do? We are going to integrate this. We are going to integrate this. Okay, when you integrate the R, what are the constant here? K is a constant. Take it out. Charge is also a constant here, source charge. Then, which is variable? X only variable. X only vary from where? Infinity to the point B. Okay, therefore we will put here infinity to R because point P is at the distance of R. Therefore, X vary from infinity to R. If you integrate here, you take this X squared from denominator to numerator, it will become X power minus 2. Then you add integrate this X power minus 2. If you integrate X power minus 2, if you integrate, what will happen? X power minus 2 plus minus 2 plus 1 minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. You will get a X power minus 1. You will get X power minus 1 by minus 1. So, therefore, what we are going to do? Minus 1 by X. If you do this, it will come 1 minus 1 by X only. okay, that x power minus 1 you brought to denominator. Okay, so then we had to put a limit here. We had to put a limit here. So minus here, this is r is there, r. Okay, here r is there. So infinity to r, minus already is there, k cube by, in place of x you had to put a r first. This minus minus kya ho gaya, plus. Then 1 by infinity minus 0, 1 by infinity 0, that is we have put 0 here. So k cube by r, this is the work done to take the charge, unit coulomb of charge, that is 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to the point P. As per the electric potential definition, the amount of work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to that point P is nothing but electric potential. Therefore, this work done is nothing but electric potential. That is here written. This work done is nothing but electric potential. What is the symbol we are using? Electric potential? V. Therefore, V is equal to, okay, in short form we can write here V is equal to KQ by R. KQ by R. KQ by R. Okay, KQ by R. So this is the electric potential. You see here, as already told you very beginning introduction, electric potential is the characteristics of electric field. Wherever the electric field will be there will be an electric potential. But finally, here electric field, sorry, electric potential is independent of test charge. Final equation, there is no test charge. Okay, so see here, earlier we are seen, what is the electric field equation? Anybody remember electric field equation? Electric field, so kq by KQ by R square, KQ by R square, KQ by R square. So, what I can write here, this can be written as KQ by R into R. What is this? What is this? KQ by R now? Electric potential. Therefore, I can put here V by R. Earlier, we had seen one relation, you know, E is equal to V by D. E is equal to V by D. Are you able to remember this formula? Electric field. Now you got this is here. E is equal to V by R. E is equal to V. This is the relation between electric field, electric potential and the distance. Are you able to follow? So remember, electric potential is a scalar quantity. Electric field is a vector quantity. So electric field is a vector quantity. Electric potential is a scalar quantity. This point you should remember. And the electric field due to a point charge is equal to electric field due to a point charge is, I just recall before we'll go to next one, KQ by R square. Electric field due to point charge is this. Electric potential due to the point charge is this. V is equal to KQ by R. All of you understood this? Vismaya? Madam Vismaya? Madam Vismaya is there? Understood? Shweta Prabhu, madam. Shweta, understood? Okay. Now, we are going to see what is the electric potential difference. Potential difference. Just now we have seen electric potential. What is electric potential? Amount of work done to bring a unit positive charge from where? from infinity to that point, that is the electric potential. V is equal to W by Q zero. V is equal to W by, this is the relation between potential, work done, charge. Okay. Now, what is the potential difference? It is a slight difference. Work done to bring unit positive charge from one point to another against the force due to electric field. Okay. Against the force due to electric field. If you are bringing 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point against the force due to electric field, then we can say it is nothing but potential difference. That is the potential difference. Where the electric potential is maximum? Very good. So, where the electric potential is maximum? Yes. Now, you see here. So, just now, I have recalled. This is charge here. And this is a point P, which is at a distance of R meter. We have brought that to what? 1 coulomb of charge. From where? Infinity to that point P. Further, how much the work is done? KQ by R. KQ by R here. This work done is nothing but electric potential KQ by R. Okay. Now we ask the question, where the electric potential is maximum? I will ask where the electric, another question I will ask to Anjit, where the electric potential is minimum? Infinity, very good. So electric potential is minimum, okay, minimum at where? Minimum at infinity. What is the minimum value? Zero. Minimum value is zero. Why? Because you put here 1 by infinity. 1 by infinity is 0. Okay, therefore, minimum value of electric potential is 0. Where it will be 0? At infinity. Now, where the what electric potential maximum? For this question, I will give answer. So, if R is here, electric potential is inversely proportional to R. Electric potential is inversely proportional to R. If R is zero, that means if you consider a point very close to the source charge, very close to the source charge. So in this case, this electric potential will be maximum. Electric potential is maximum. So electric potential is inversely proportional to distance. Clear all of you? Okay. So this is the variation of electric potential and the distance. Near the source charge, infinity is the potential difference. Now, we are going to consider a source charge as it is. And we are going to consider a point B, which is at distance of x meter. Okay, so this point P is at a distance of x meter from the source charge Q. Now our aim is to bring a 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to the where? Point B. For that, small amount of work is done. Same thing only. So, for this, we are going to consider a 1 coulomb of charge is initially where? At this point P. At this point P here. What is the distance of point? Initially at the point what P here. Okay. Now, we are going to bring a water, this 1 coulomb of charge from where? P to Q through small distance. What is the formula? Small amount of work done here. F into dr, F into dx here, F into dx, because small distance is dx, F vector dot dx vector. So electric field is this direction, electric field is this direction, and we are going to move the charge in the opposite direction. Therefore angle is 180, angle is 180 here, angle is 180. Okay, dx da enna panna porunga, the separation between two point P and Q. புரியுதா? இப்ப என்னன்னா, what is the potential difference between A and B? We are going to calculate now. What is the potential difference between point A and B? அதுக்காக என்ன பண்ண போறோம்? First we are going to calculate small amount of work done to move the 1 coulomb of charge from where? P to Q. புரியுதா? Are you able to understand? So cos 180 is minus 1. Therefore, minus kq by x square into dx. This is a small amount of work done to move the charge from where? Move the charge from P to Q here. That is small distance dx. What is the total amount of work done to move the charge from where? A to B. For that, what we have to do? We have to integrate this. We are going to integrate this small amount of work done. Okay. So with the limit, distance of point A is RA. And the distance of point B is RB. Distance of point B is RB. And here x is nothing but distance of P from O. Now, limit is here. It is vary from RA to RB. Now, we will take a constant quantity outside the integral. That is kq. So their variable only x here. So if you integrate this 1 by x squared, you will get what? X power minus 1 by x. Are you able to follow? Minus 1 by x. After integration of this, should I what explain how to get this? The x power minus 2. So how we are getting x power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. So you'll get x power minus 1 by minus 1. You'll get to minus 1 by x. Minus. Children, are you able to follow? Yes. Minus 1 by x. Now I am going to apply limit. RA to RB. Limit A. Okay. Then see here, this minus minus plus A. Minus minus plus. Now you apply limit here. In place of x, you put here rb. The b under the suffix, remember. B into the suffix. Rb. Subscript of r. Ra. Distance of point A from the source charge. Are you able to follow how to write Ra and Rb? This A and B should be written in the subscript of r. Now, in place of x, you have to put what? Rb. 1 by RB minus 1 by RA. This is the, sorry, 1.2, another, that is A to B here. So you will get among these two point A and B, among these two point A and B, which you have a higher potential? B. That's how we are seeing B is inversely proportional to R. B is inversely proportional to R. The point which is very close to the source charge B, it will have a potential VB, and this point A will have a potential VA. Now, as V is inversely proportional to R, the point B will have a higher potential. That is, VB is greater than VA. VB is greater than VA. So as per the potential difference definition, this amount of work done to move 1 coulomb of charge from A to B is nothing but VB minus VA. The work done than the potential difference. So since what point B is, no, this is the electric potential difference. So q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by rb minus 1 by ra. Understood? Are you able to follow? Okay. Now you see here. So far we have seen potential difference and potential, electric potential. Yes. Now, okay. See, electric field is the gradient of electric potential. Electric field is the gradient of electric potential. What is the meaning of electric field is a gradient of electric potential? So that is E is equal to minus dV by dx. We already come across pressure gradient, temperature gradient in 11th standard. Are you able to recollect? Even velocity gradient in coefficient of viscosity, velocity gradient. So like that, the another quantity is called here potential gradient. Potential gradient is nothing but difference of potential by separation between two points. Now you see here we are having source charge Q. Are you able to see the diagram? Children, able to see the diagram? Yes, source charge Q. It is what placed at point O. Now, the point A is at a distance X. We are going to take the unit positive charge from where? B to A. This is already you know. That is F into dx into cos 180. Okay. And see here, in place of F, you know, I am going to put here E. Why? Because what is the electric field at this point A due to this charge Q? What is the electric field at the point A due to the charge Q? KQ by X squared. KQ by X squared. Force also KQ by X squared only. Force experienced by a 1 coulomb of charge. Therefore, E value and F value is same here, KQ by X square. That is the electric field due to source charge. Okay, at this point A. So we will get a, in place of F, you will put here E. Therefore, work then to take the charge from where? From B to A, we will put here. So how to write is here WBA suffix ledanu unde subscript ledanu. WBA means work done to take the 1 coulomb of charge from B to A is nothing but minus E into dx, so by definition of potential difference in there, this work done is nothing but what? Potential difference. This work done is nothing but, hey, what is the potential difference? Da? Amount of work done to bring 1 coulomb of charge from where? One point. Hey, one point to another, potential difference. In the B, we are taking to A. That is how much work done? WBA. As per the definition of potential difference, this work done to take the 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point is nothing but potential difference. Here, what is the symbol we are using here? VB. In place of VA minus VB, here A is very close here. In place of VA minus VB, I used here DV. But therefore, dv is equal to minus e into dx. Therefore, e is equal to minus dv by dx. But you see here, what is dv? Potential difference between these two points. What is dx? Separation between these two points. this quantity is called a potential gradient. Potential gradient. If you see here, potential gradient is negative of the electric field. Otherwise, we can say electric field is the negative of potential gradient. Negative of potential gradient. Potential gradient. What is the unit of potential gradient? You see here. First, let me tell you about what is the unit of potential. What is the potential definition? Anybody? Potential definition? Anybody? Tell me. Potential is nothing but amount of work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. That means, what is the amount of work done? Unit, joule. Unit of charge is coulomb. Joule per coulomb is nothing but unit of potential. Joule per coulomb is the unit of potential difference. Okay. If suppose this joule per coulomb is nothing but volt. This joule per coulomb is nothing but volt. If you bring a one coulomb of charge from infinity to that point, I repeat once again, if you bring a one coulomb of charge from infinity to that point, then that electric potential at that point is said to be 1 volt. 1 volt. 1 joule by 1 coulomb is nothing but 1 volt. Up here, name the physical quantity having same unit volt. There are two physical quantity. What are those? One is electric potential, another one is potential difference. Very good. So one is the electric potential, another one is potential difference. Now you tell me, what is the unit of potential gradient? What is the unit of potential gradient? Volt per meter. Very good. Volt per meter. Okay, this is the definition of potential gradient. What this negative sign indicates here? Negative sign indicates here potential decreases in the direction of electric field. See here. So meaning here is, here all of you understood. This is the direction of electric field. This is the direction of electric field. Which direction? See here. This is the direction of electric field. And in this direction, what will happen? When you move away from the charge, the electric field what decreases, and then potential also decreases. Okay. So when you move along the direction of electric field, potential is decreased. That is the meaning here. Potential also decreases. Potential decreases in the direction of electric field. Are you able to understand all of you? Yeah. What is the definition between electric field and the potential gradient? Minus dv by dx. Understood? Okay. The potential difference. Unit of potential difference also volt only. How to define 1 volt? Potential difference between 2 points is 1 volt. If 1 joule of work is done in moving 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another against the force due to electric field. Okay. So far we are seeing what is electric potential due to point charge, kq by r. Remember, what is the electric potential due to the point charge, kq by r. What is the electric field due to the point charge, kq by r square. Next bar, potential difference also we have seen. Now electric dipole we have seen already. What is the electric dipole? minus Q. Okay, and this is plus Q. Okay, these two are separated by distance, na? 2a. These two are separated by distance, 2a. This is nothing but what is this? Center of the dipole. This is nothing but center of the dipole. Now, what we are going to do? What is the electric field? What is the electric field due to the electric dipole on the axial line? Earlier we have seen electric field on the axial line of electric dipole. Similarly, now we are going to see what is the electric potential on the axial line of this electric dipole. For this, I am going to consider one point P at a distance of r meter from the where? Center of the electric dipole. R meter from the center of the electric dipole. Okay. Now, what is the distance of P from Q? What is the distance of P from Q? Distance of P from Q. R minus A. R minus A. What is the distance of P from minus Q? This is R plus A. This is the R plus A. Okay. Now, what is our aim here? This topic is, what is the electric field? Sorry, electric potential. What is the net electric potential at the point P due to the electric dipole? The point P we are considered on the axial line. Are you able to follow? Okay. Now you see here. Now, first, what is the electric potential due to this charge Q? That is, we will take it as here where it is placed. This is A. This is A. This is a point B. What is the electric potential at P due to the charge plus Q? It is placed where? Point B. Just now we are seeing, now what is the electric potential due to the point charge? KQ by R. KQ by R. What is the potential at P due to this charge Q? KQ by R minus A. R minus A. Are you able to follow? Children, are you able to follow? Yes. What is the electric potential at P due to this charge minus Q? Where it is placed at the point A? It is an electric potential is a scalar. And the electric field is a vector. We are not incorporated the negative sign. But we have to take into account that the nature of the charge also. Therefore, what is the electric potential at P due to this charge minus Q? Minus KQ by, what is the value here? R plus A. See here, and what we have done, we have written magnitude and we mentioned the direction to calculate the electric field on the axial line. But when you are calculating electric potential at the point P to the electric dipole, so we are taking what nature of the charge also into our calculation. Now, what is the electric potential, net potential at P? This is the scalar quantity. We are going to add here. So we have calculated this, and we have calculated this too. Net potential is, we had to add both VA plus VB. Now, what is the common here? Q by, that is K is a constant. That is K value is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, small k value. Okay. So, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Then, what is the other value? 1 by R minus A minus 1 by R plus A. So, Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now, you see here. what will happen? Denominator is here r minus a into r plus a. Which formula you have to use? A minus b into a plus b. A square minus b square. So r square minus a square. The numerator, how it will go? R plus a. Here it will come minus r minus a. When you are doing here r plus a minus r minus into minus plus a here, this r minus r get cancel, a plus a 2a. So you will get a, what is q into 2a? P, what is p? Electric dipole moment. So v is equal to p divided by nache, p divided by 4 pi epsilon into r square minus a square. Suppose here already a is very much less than r, therefore a square can be neglected. A square can be neglected. If you neglect, what the value it will come? P by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. அங்க என்ன வந்தது? ஆக்சுவல் லைன்ல பாரு, 2p / 4 பை எப்சிலன் r கியூப் வந்தது. இந்த r ஸ்கொயர் ஒரு r குறஞ்சிரும். ஓகே, சோ திஸ் இஸ் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரிக் பொட்டன்ஷியல் ஆன் தி ஆக்சுவல் லைன் ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரிக் டைபோல். see here, சோ திஸ் ஈக்குவேஷன் ஹியர் இட் இஸ். ஓகே, வாட் யூ ஹேட் ரைட், திஸ் இஸ் தி ஒன் யூ ஹேட் ரைட். So V is equal to AQ by R squared. R you had right, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, not a Q. Q varadhu, enna varum? P, P. So P divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R squared. This is the electric potential on the axial line of the electric dipole. All of you able to understood? Yes. Then what we have seen there in electric field? On the equatorial line we have seen. Am I correct? That is the next topic. Electric potential on the equatorial line of electric dipole. So, electric potential on the equatorial line of electric dipole, that is we are going to see. Okay, now see here, we are going to consider what is the next topic, electric potential on the equatorial line of electric dipole. This is a charge minus q and this is a charge plus q. What is the separation here? 2a. This is center of the dipole. This is the equatorial line of the electric dipole. On the equatorial line, we are going to consider a point P. We are going to consider a point P, which is at a distance of r meter. Now, I am going to join the point P with the minus Q. Similarly, join the point Q. Okay. This is, let us say, point B here, this is A. Now, what is the distance of P from what point B? This is the A here. What will happen now? This is the R squared plus A squared whole to the power half. R, this will be square root. Okay, what is the electric field at P due to this charge plus Q? EB is equal to, now remember, KQ by R squared plus A squared. Message is coming. Hold the power off. Then VA value, how much it will come? VA value minus KQ minus kq by r square plus a square whole to the power under square root. What is the net electric field at this point B? Both you will add it. BA plus BB. What is the value? What is the net electric field at the point B? Now, net potential at the point B. Both add. How much it will come? Then the magnitude is same. Zero. So, electric potential on the equatorial line of electric dipole is on the equatorial line of electric dipole is zero. Zero. So that is we are going to see through the notes. Just see here any doubt you can ask now. Just see here same diagram. Let us consider the electric dipole consisting of charges minus q and plus q separated by distance 2a. Let p be a point. This is the point we have considered. Okay, which is at a distance of r meter. This is r on the equatorial line of the electric dipole. Okay, at the distance r from the midpoint of electric dipole, electric potential due to the charge minus q is minus q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square plus a square whole to the power of, then due to the positive charge q, q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square plus a square whole to the power of. Net electric potential, since it is a scalar quantity, we can add both the value. Therefore, V is equal to VA plus VB. Then if you are adding, what is the net electric potential? Zero. Okay. This is about your this one. Clear all of you? This topic we will see tomorrow class.